Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. You turned me into a zombie, but I already loved brains before. You guys are in for a treat. Or trick. Whichever you like. This is a very spooky episode of Dear Blocko. That was a vampire. Anyway, this is where I answer your questions about the real world or my world. Let's get started with the first question. Stacy asks, Dear Blocko, can a dead person come back to life? I love you, Blocko. Hey, thanks. I love you too. Now to answer your question about dead people coming back to life, in a way, yeah, they can. There's something known as the Lazarus phenomenon, and it's where someone springs back to life after they had appeared to be clinically dead. It's defined as a delayed return of spontaneous circulation, also known as ROSC, after you had already stopped giving someone CPR. A 2007 study reported that these delayed ROSCs usually occur within about 10 minutes, recommending that you should try and still passively monitor someone for at least those 10 minutes after stopping CPR before confirming their death. 10 minutes might not seem like a lot of time, but if that isn't enough to give you a bad case of taphophobia, I don't know what will. Next question comes from Lizzie Theo. Dear Blocko, what causes our nightmares to be so scary? Well, first off, if you're having nightmares, don't worry too much about it, because they're a totally normal thing to have. They're more common in children, though adults can certainly get them too. But since nightmares can be pretty scary and can cause some people to wake up or lose sleep over them, I totally get why you'd want to learn more about why your dreams can be so spooky. The exact reason is a little bit of a mystery, but some people believe that scary dreams are a manifestation of sorts for any real dangers or problems that you come across in your life. Anxiety and depression may also play a role here, causing you to have nightmares along with things like PTSD. Others point to certain medications like antidepressants being the culprit. It could be any of these things, or maybe a combination of them, that make your nightmares so scary. It could also be just random. All I know is that me and my meddling friends here need to find out who that spooky monster really is before they strike again. Aha, gotcha. It was Grandma all along? Grandma? Now it's time for questions about me or my world. Mei Lee asks, Dear Blocko, show us your baby pictures? Oh man, this is embarrassing. I mean, I have a couple. Okay, here, take a look. I was so young. Here's my first birthday. Oh no, my first Halloween. Can you believe my animator put me in that? Oh, wow. Oh, and here's what I look like on my first day of YouTube. Look at those arms. They're so attached and limited. Terry20 says, Dear Blocko, please give us a tour of your world. Well, my world is massive and limitless, but I suppose I can give you a quick tour. Here's Blocktown Park. Here's the city of Blocktropolis. Here's where the failed pixel experiments of 1997 led to a quarantine town filled with horribly corrupted blocky beings. And here is the candy gumdrop Smile Land. How cute. There's a lot more to show you, but then we'd be here forever. Oh no, they're escaping. Everyone to the bunker. Don't let them catch you. So, do you have any questions about your world or mine? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. You should also follow me on Twitter, where I'll be announcing some really cool things in the coming months. Wanna watch more Dear Blocko? Check out the last one we did here. What would happen if you never washed your hands? Well, apart from all the dirt and other gunk that would likely build up on your hands, you'd be leaving a bunch of germs on them. Thank you so much for watching. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.